college football now and the Rose Bowl race. Three teams are now tied for the right to go to Pasadena and most likely face number one Michigan, the Washington State Cougars. One of those teams looked strong when they needed to yesterday against Stanford. We're late in the game. Stanford taking the lead right here on the Troy Walters punt return for touchdown, 77 yards. But Michael Black would come back for the Cougs, 4 yards in the touchdown. Cougs win 38-28, setting up a very, very important Apple Cup game next week.
My first start was up there, and I didn't know what the meaning of it was then, but I know what it is now, and you know, that's something I've never done, is beat the Huskies. So it's a goal out there for me. It's a goal out there for the rest of this team. You know, we haven't been to a Rose Bowl either. If we win and the Bruins win, that's the way we do it. But we still got to play a hard game next week. It's going to be a battle.
Playing for the Rose Bowl, it is Washington State. Now Saturday in Pullman, the Cougs are trying to come out of the fog and stay in the Rose Bowl hunt against Stanford. Ryan Leaf here on third down. He's going to find Kevin McKenzie. That gives him a first and goal. That would set up a touchdown. The Cougs have the early lead. The fans loving it at Martin Stadium. Then in the second half, Leaf dropping back. He's going to find Chris Jackson for the second time in the end zone. Wazoo would lead by 13, but back comes Stanford. The reverse to Damon Dunn, and he is going to pay the price right here. The camera guy didn't want to pay the price and got out of the way. Cardinal took a one-point lead, but Michael Black would cap off a great day with the game winner. The Cougs win in the record crowd of 40,000-plus, thinking Rose Bowl.
That's what separates this team from any other, I think, is the belief we have in each other and the belief we have that we were going into the season, that we were going to be something special. This team's been through enough tragedies, things off the field, things on the field and stuff, and it was time for this team to step up, senior leadership and all, and they've done a good job, but, you know, it's not going to be achieved until next weekend.
How many Cougars in America have a dream of going to Rose Bowl? You know, every Cougar that's ever been a Cougar has that dream. You know, that's the vision of our program, to go to the Rose Bowl, to win it, and to graduate everybody that we possibly can. That's our mission. What these players did is now it's not a dream. It's a goal, and it's darn realistic goal, isn't it?
Now, Washington State is in the Rose Bowl if they beat Washington in the Apple Cup and either UCLA wins or Arizona State loses. The Huskies out of contention for Pasadena. Your place for all the Apple Cup hype right here on KNDO. We'll have reports throughout the week. Now, another sports news going on today. The Mariners have turned the New York Yankees down on a trade offer that would have brought closer Mariano Rivera to Seattle. The team says they need a starting pitcher to replace the big unit. And the Seahawks will be without wide receiver Brian Blades and possibly defensive back Darryl Williams up. And for Washington State, it is simple. They need to win the Apple Cup and have either UCLA beat USC or Arizona State lose to Arizona. Now, Saturday in Pullman, the Cougs were trying to come out of the fog and stay in the Rose Bowl hunting at Stanford. Ryan Leaf here on third down is going to hit Kevin McKenzie. That'll give him first and goal. It would lead to a touchdown. The Cougs had the early lead. Then in the second half, as the crowd celebrated Martin Stadium, Leaf would find his favorite receiver on this day, Chris Jackson. Second TD connection of the day for them. Wazoo would lead by 13. Stanford, though, would rally back. Here the reverse to Damon Dunn, and he's going to get the ball just inside as he pays the price. The Cardinal took a one-point lead, but the Cougs rally to win it. Michael Black capping off a great day with the game winner. The Cougs win in the record crowd of 40,000-plus, thinking Rose.